holy shit, I'm going to a dog show. Crazy, right? First dog show post-COVID. Totally pumped. Me and my cheese zit, because yes, I stress eat with cheese and then I get zits. We're headed to South Carolina to go to our first show post-COVID. Holy crap, totally pumped, but stressed.
So did you have fun?
Yes! Talking about our first one.
You asked for the adventures, I'm sharing them with another day in the life. So be sure to like this video, share it with your friends, leave a comment below on your post-COVID dog show thoughts, and then of course, subscribe if you haven't already so that you can ring that little bell and not miss a single episode.
Don't know what to expect. It's our first show post-COVID. I mean, I've got my whole stockpile of masks. I have tons of them. You have to show and go, can't hang around, which is kind of sad because I'm used to the whole hanging around, being with my friends. That's not going to happen. I've got Billy and Easy, who this is their first show. Normally, would have already had my puppies at shows and gotten them accustomed to show environment and the sights and the sounds and all that. And of course, I haven't had an opportunity. So this is their first time traveling long distance. I've got Boo and Snack because we're trying to finish Snack. Yay. Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what life is like at dog shows post-COVID. Staying with Lana, which is always a good time. I posted on my Facebook account my first post-COVID drama, and that is the superintendent used United States Postal Service to mail me the fact that my entries that I paid for all 4 days, I didn't get in. I only got in one day, and that's on Thursday, which giving me a day and a half's notice was not cool. So, first suggestion, superintendents, email everybody who does an online entry. I'm not paying extra fees for the convenience of online entries to then be completely inconvenienced and told, after all of my plans have been made, a day and a half before I'm supposed to leave, sorry, you're not entered. Totally sucks. Now, they are crediting my account, so I'm getting my money back, but yeah, not cool. But I also understand this is going to be a learning experience for everybody. I'm willing to take it this one time. Not again. Thank you. So, why am I going for one day? Snack needs a major to finish. I am hoping we get a major. Also, Lana and I had other plans, so I'm making the trip. It'll be awesome. We're having a good time. I can't film at the show. Thank you. But I will share everything I experience. I guarantee you that. Here we go. On to our very first dog show post-COVID.
From that point forward, I made the 9-hour drive to South Carolina. Now, it's really not 9 hours, but for me it is, because, well, I have to stop and pee. You know, all that water I drink. Like, I have to stop a lot. Like, a lot. But I made it through Florida and into Georgia during a rainstorm and wind gusts over bridges, jamming to music and sucking on my water bottle, and then, of course, doing some more peeing. Until I finally made it into the rural roads of South Carolina, where cell reception and internet connections are far and few between. Thank God for Apple Music being downloaded to my phone. I made it eventually to Lana's, where I crashed from complete exhaustion, only to wake at the ass crack of dawn for my one and only show of the 4-day weekend. Many of you may have remembered that I was suspended for 3 months, and I really only got to do 2 dog shows back in February, you know, before Ronageddon hit. So, my break from dog shows has been pretty long, and it was all kind of surreal for me. I am not necessarily a morning person, and the only thing I've ever gotten up early for in my life was to run during the quarantine and to go to dog shows. One thing I have not missed is wearing pantyhose. I hate pantyhose. Like, seriously dislike them tremendously. But I put them back on and slipped into my signature retro-styled Shelby and Palmer dress, applied that red lipstick, and off to the showgrounds I went. pulling out that Best in Show trolley from the back of my car, setting it up with the beds and the bottles and filling it with dogs. Oh my God, it all came rushing back and it felt so good. And away we went. Here are some of my observations. First, I love the entrance and the exit points in the show ring. It most definitely kept the flow, well, flowing. It was awesome. Another love is how we're able to pick up our own armbands. No more congregating, no more having to wait. We all get to be, you know, adults and take care of our own responsibilities. Cool, right? The exhibitors were all face masked up. And while there may have been some complaining and concerns all over Facebook,
can't see,
I didn't hear a single issue at the show. It's a nice way to embrace our new way of life. I also learned that it's kind of a mute point to wear my, you know, signature red lipstick, because guess what? No one's going to see it. And it's actually just going to get all over the inside of my face mask. So yeah. There's that. Some of the not so pleasant things about post-COVID dog shows is we can't hang with our peeps. It's really show and go. The show site is quite barren, like a ghost town in a way. It just makes me so sad. As much as I love the competition and the sport and the chance to be with so many amazing dogs, it's sad that we can't be with our people. It makes my heart hurt. It's just not the same. I do hope that that does change. Also, no matter how much I preach we should all be lead breaking our dogs during our downtime, yeah, well, I should probably practice what I preach. Easy, she did great. Billy, yeah, not so much. And Snack, she's been basically thoroughly enjoying couch life since November and looked up at me in the ring like, you want me to what? Yeah. No. We got second. So the other disappointing thing is it's going to take some time to get our dogs back into the show mindset. I say this all the time. I don't go to a dog show with the only intention being to bring home a ribbon. I realize that a large part of it is really just a $30 confirmation class. There is nothing that can replace the sights and sounds and smells of an actual dog show. You can go to a million and one confirmation classes. It's just not the same, people. You need to get your dogs trained at dog shows themselves. I watched a lot of class dogs struggling to adapt to this whole foreign concept. We all have to help our dogs get back into the swing of things, or at the least learn what a dog show is. And it's gonna be so hard with the shows being so few and far between. I guess in a way it's kind of leveling the playing field a bit, right? I really do hope that clubs are able to put together more matches, and that should help in the meantime. Something that I think this entire sport desperately needs to go back to, like in the good old days. And the rest of my trip? I got to unwind with my dogs, who absolutely loved the chance to be away from home and, you know, exploring a bit. A completely new environment with all new friends. And of course, I got to hang with my dear friends and learn that spades is quite the wicked game. Also, that those that love you the most will make you eat carbs, and it's okay. I'm going to live. That it doesn't seem to matter what state I'm in. Baristas can't seem to understand. I want my coffee black. Nothing in it. Fully leaded. Sugary syrup is disgusting. Yes, I went back and had them get me a new one. Yes, I'm that Karen. Also, the gas prices in South Carolina make my soul happy. I know it's only a couple of dollars at the end of the day, but it feels so good. Additionally, training your dogs for long distance car travel was also part of the sport. And as a person who drinks a gallon of water a day, when you're traveling with young puppies, potty breaks are much more frequent. And wearing a poop paw print on your boob is not unheard of. Ultimately, I am very proud of our sport and of all of the people in it. We handled our new reality like the champions we truly are. We can do this, people.
Oh, it feels good. It's like really a coach your hands.
Yeah, it's good stuff.
But some of them don't.
No, it's good stuff.
Oh my God, it smells awful.
And maybe this whole experience will teach us new ways to make an already pretty cool sport even more streamlined. At a minimum, we are proving to the world that we really rock, and we will survive Coronageddon.